Sam. So let's go ahead and roll that.
Is that it is Freddy versus Jason. It's the first time they've been paired together. You know, they each had their own fan following, so there's been a lot of anticipation over this.
I think what's scary about Freddy, I think it's the violation of privacy. Not only does he know your most private thoughts and you can exploit them, he's in your bedroom. He's under your bed. He's looking in that mirror when you brush your teeth. He's in that private, safe space.
What's the matter, Lori? Miss your wake-up call?
Jason is obviously much bigger, much stronger than Freddy. Freddy is much smarter than Jason and has a whole world unto himself where he's sort of Lord and God. He uses that to manipulate Jason and to take advantage of Jason, but ultimately, you know, Jason relies on his strength to try and overcome Freddy.
Freddy needs to install fear into his potential victims. The children, the relatives, the offspring of the original vigilante parents that burned him.
Why are you the next victim? I remember one of the first times I was on set, I was nervous. Of course, it was my first movie and I was terrified. He made me feel very comfortable.
Ronnie just, he has a strange popping culture sensibility. He just sees his stories that way.
He is just bringing a wonderful imagination to this movie. He's taking Freddy Jason to a new level.
The makeup is, you know, the technology has improved and changed since the last time I did Freddy.
We've had about 72 different gangs and makeups to build in the past 8 weeks. The crew here in the shop is 31 people in the shop and another dozen people on set to help apply the makeups. Freddy's makeup, we're using foam latex, which has been the norm for many, many years. Same with Jason's makeup, that also is foam latex. All of our bodies are made out of silicone. The beauty of the silicone is that it resembles skin that much more than foam latex. It's translucent, so the camera will want to travel into the material.
It's not Freddy fights Jason, it's Freddy versus Jason. There's a lot of mind game, a lot of manipulation. Come on. I will tell my fans that Freddy takes it like Freddy keeps it.
Place your bets.
Which is the rave. Because, you know, Freddy likes to take the teenage vernacular and kind of jam it back down their throat.
This Everclear is kicking my ass.
Thank you.
Oh, shit.
Burn, motherfucker!
Freddy versus Jason, there's a sequence at a rave, which is all teeners all the time, and Jason wreaks havoc, and it's pretty funny. Yeah.
Welcome your special guest MC for today's event, the most famous voice in all of sports, Mr. Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bally's Las Vegas, and welcome to the beginning of the official countdown for an event over 20 years in the making. 1 month from today, on August 15th, the world will be witness to the battle of the century. Are you ready? Yeah! Movie fans and fight fans of all ages, are you ready?
Yeah!
For the thousands in attendance and the millions upon millions around the world, this is the beginning of the moment we've all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! And now let's meet the principals. Introducing first to my right, with over 1,000 career kills, he's come back to life 7 times. Hailing from Elm Street, the man with the curly hair, the Springboard Selection, Freddy the Tower of Power, Jason Voorhees! Gentlemen, please, at this time, we would like to have the weigh-in. Could you please step backstage here behind him? Mr. Krueger? Mr. Voorhees, please? Back here, please, for the official weigh-in. First up on the scales, ladies and gentlemen. Boy, I've done some heavyweight fights, but this is... First up on the scales, ladies and gentlemen, Freddy the Springwood Slasher Krueger.
Stab him in the face!
Freddy Krueger, 174¾ pounds!
Yeah!
Freddy Krueger! Next up on the scales, ladies and gentlemen, Jason Voorhees! This can't be right. 322... Excuse me, one second. 275 pounds even. Jason Voorhees, 275 pounds. Gentlemen, at this time, you'll have to answer some questions from the press, but we'd like to bring out, here to join you at the desks, the director and producer. I've never been so nervous in my life, ladies and gentlemen. Of Freddy vs. Jason, please welcome Mr. Ronnie Yu and Mr. Sean Cunningham. First question, please.
Jason, there's been a great deal of controversy about your training methods. How do you respond to that?
No comment.
Thank you very much.
Next question, please.
Wait, what's the matter? Can't you speak for yourself, hockey puck? Gotta rely on 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon over there, huh?
Do we have another question from the press, please?
Yeah, this question is for Freddy. Freddy, it seems like this fight is so long overdue. Why has it taken so long for you two to get together?
Well, first of all, my little piggy, that's Mr. Krueger to you! Biatch. Took so long. I've been waiting for hockey puck over here to pass the urine test. Steroid City, get it?
Do we have another question from the press?
Jason, what's your strategy for dealing with the more agile Freddy?
We wanted to thank our host, Bally's. Please no subs.
Excuse
me. The balance bar people.
Yeah, excuse me. You're not really answering the question. No. Okay.
Hey, girl, come over here. I'll keep you safe.
Next question, please.
Will be your most difficult challenge in fighting Jason.
Waiting to see if this goalie here can find a ring.
And we have time for one last question, please.
Freddy.
What?
Do you feel your ability to speak and thus talk trash gives you a distinct advantage in intimidating Jason before your big fight?
I don't need no stinking distinct advantage. The mama's boy here, he's big, he's dumb, he's slow, he's stupid, and he ain't got no style. Place your bets, people. See you in the ring, Voorhees.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was the final question from the press at this time. Here to announce the opening Bally's betting line for Freddy versus Jason, please welcome Bally's Chief Odds Maker, Director of Race Sportsbook Operations, Mr. John Avello.
Thank you, Michael. Good morning, everyone. Over the past few months, I have spent countless hours watching Freddy and Jason's previous fights and movies. I've surfed online sites dedicated to Freddy and Jason for inklings to help establish a favorite. I've also paid close attention to the tail of the tape. At 5'10" and 175 pounds, Freddy...
5'10" and a half, punk.
Freddy is giving up a lot of size to Jason at 6'6" and 275. But Freddy overcomes that with a distinct advantage in speed and agility.
Yeah.
Jason has 20% more kills with 1,200 versus 1,000 for Freddy. But Freddy's weapon of choice, his claw hand, is much more efficient than Jason's machete. But Jason's bounce back ability, his 10 times coming back to life versus Freddy 7, shows a resiliency that was a deciding factor in setting the odds. And now, I am finally prepared to release my opening line live via closed circuit television from the Las Vegas Bally's Race and Sportsbook.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Those are the official odds. Jason is a 2-3 favorite over Freddy, who is 7-5 as an underdog. Jason, 2-3 favorite. Freddy, a 7-5 underdog. Security. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the press conference, I believe, is over at this time. We thank you for coming to Bally's Las Vegas. Don't forget, as you can see by the animosity of the two combatants here on the stage, on August 15th, it's going to be the rumble between Freddy versus Jason. August 15th, we'll see you there, everybody. Thank you for coming.
Together,
start up with this bad dog.